Hello children, how are you all? Hope you are enjoying. Good morning, this is Asha Best. I am your EVS teacher. Today we will discuss the first class 4 EVS chapter, that is types of houses. First of all, I want to welcome you all in your new class. You must be very excited. So let's begin with our studies. The first chapter is types of houses. Dear student, as we all know that we all, not only human being but animals also, need a house to live and survive, because house is a basic necessity. Yes, house as a basic necessity for humans as well as for animals. We require house to keep ourselves safe from heat, cold and rain. We live in a house which keeps us, or which makes us comfortable, which saves us from thieves and robbers. Like if we'll stay out at night, what will happen? It may be dangerous for all of us. That's why we construct house. So house always keeps us safe. Few animals we keep as pets. So for such animals we make houses at our home only, and there are many animals, those who live in their natural habitat like in forest. Building a house, dear children, building a house is totally depends upon these three factors, and these three factors are the weather condition in the area we are going to construct house, the material available, like whatever the thing required to construct a house, that are available in a particular area or not. The third thing, that is the most important thing I guess, that is economic condition, like how much money you can spend to construct a house. So these are the elements which we require while constructing a house. You can see the picture over there on the screen. Hope you are enjoying the presentation and getting the concept too. Now, there are different types of houses. Different types of houses are built in different places and regions. Let's discuss houses in cold region first. The cold region of the Arctic is completely covered with snow throughout the year. Means Arctic region always covered with snow. So the people living in these areas will make houses using slabs of ice. Can they use wood, cement and other things? No, they cannot use such things, because in the areas where heavy snowfall occurs, there they use slabs of ice to construct their houses. Now, can you guess what will be the shape of such houses? The shape of these houses is dome. They construct dome shaped houses. And do you know what these houses are called? These houses are called igloos. Eskimos or Inuits make igloos and they live in these houses in Arctic region. Then comes, yes, the picture of igloo. Hope you are liking the picture. This is the picture you are drawing right from class 1. You know that these are igloo. Now next comes wooden houses. These are the wooden houses. You can see here, wooden houses are constructed in America because these areas are very cold throughout the year and they have much forest region also. People built wooden houses or log cabins there. They use wood because there is plenty of wood. Because there are forest areas where wood is easily available. Also, wood is a good insulator and keeps the cold out. Means when you construct a house using wood, it keeps you warm because the walls of the house will always remain hot. Yes, then comes, yes, I'll show you the picture of wooden houses. You can look here, see how beautiful these houses are looking. Now, what kind of houses are made in dry regions? In hot and dry areas, houses are built with flat roofs. Means, unki jo chhat hoti hai, wo kaisi hogi? Flat hogi. Theek hai? They will plaster their houses wall with mud. Mitti ke plaster usme kiya jayega. Because mud houses keep the house cool from inside. Mud houses are constructed in Mexico. And Egyptians were the first who built mud houses. You know, they also paint their houses with white color because white color reflects the heat of the sun and keeps the house cool from inside. Let's see the picture of mud houses. Yes, you can have a look. These are the beautiful mud houses. Then comes houses in areas with heavy rainfall. The areas where heavy rainfall occur, what kind of houses these people build? In places where rainfall, or you can say, yes, heavy rainfall occurs almost throughout the year. Here people make houses on stilts, means on the raised, they make raised houses on the wooden poles. These stilt houses are made to protect people from natural disasters, natural calamities like floods, heavy rainfall. Because due to heavy rainfall, sometimes the houses washes away along with the heavy water. But when the houses are constructed on poles, then these houses will keep you safe during flood and other natural calamities. Such houses are found in the eastern region of India, like the northeast part of India. They make stilt houses. Let's have a look. Stilt houses here. Yes, see. These are the pictures of stilt houses. You can see the poles there. On the screen, these houses are created on the poles. They are raised houses. They are above the ground. You can see stairs are also there from which they can get inside as well as they can come out of their houses. Okay, now types of houses as per the availability of space and fund. Okay, while constructing a house, you should always, people always keep in mind that how much fund they are having, how much land area that they are having, then only they will be able to construct a house, as they decide earlier that how much money they need to spend to construct houses. In this series, the first comes temporary houses. Temporary houses, naam se hi pata chal raha hai, aise ghar jo permanent nahi hote, jinko use karne ke baad aap nikal kar apne saath wapas le ja sakte hain. These can be built for vacations. Like whenever you go for vacations with your family and friends, that time you can take these houses along with you. You can fix those houses and then enjoy your vacation. While coming back from there, you can take the houses along with you. Sometimes they are built because of the climate of a region. Like climatic condition also decides you have to make temporary houses. For example, coastal areas, they make temporary houses like wood or coconut leaves by the fishermen. They use wood or coconut leaves in the coastal areas. Samudra ke kinare wale jo ilake hain, wahan par log kya karte hain? Lakdi aur coconut leaves ko use karke ghar banate hain. Basically the fishermen jo machli pakadte hain, jinka kaam hai machli pakadna, they make such kind of temporary houses to live in. Then comes tents. Tents are the folding houses जिनको कि आप कैंपिंग के लिए जाते हो, वहाँ पर फिक्स करते हो, जब वापस आते हो, then you fold it and come back. Yes, these houses are waterproof. Like if it is raining and you have fixed your tent, then the water will not come inside and it will keep you safe from rain. After tents comes caravans. These are the movable house also. These are the houses which are made on wheels. Means they dwell on wheels. They move from one place to another on wheels. Earlier, these type of houses are pulled by animals like horses, bullock carts. But nowadays, these houses are pulled by car or trucks. These are also the temporary, or you can say the movable houses, which can be easily taken from one place to another. Now comes houseboats. Houseboats are the houses which are also known as floating houses. Inko kya kaha jata hai? Floating houses. These houses you can find in the places where water bodies are like lakes. They are generally found in Kashmir, Kerala, and in Hong Kong, Holland. These are the places where you can see the houseboats. These are the houses which are made on water and they can float easily on water. Then let's see the picture of temporary houses. You can see how beautiful these pictures are. You can see tent there also. Now let's discuss permanent houses or modern houses. Modern houses, dear children, especially these houses are built using pakka material like cement, stone, iron, wood. These are the materials used to construct such houses. They may be big or small, simple or multi-storied buildings. Multi-storied buildings in city areas, especially where the land area is less, there people don't construct separate houses, but there they construct multi-storied building with many apartments. There people live. We find people living mostly in 2 or 3 bedroom flats, or you can say apartments. Then comes bungalows. Basically are constructed by rich people. They need larger space. These kind of houses are huge in size. They have lawns, they have parking space also, as well as these houses are very expensive. This is all about the chapter. Now let's come towards assignment part. After studying the whole chapter, I'll give you assignment. Before that, you can have a look to these beautiful pictures of permanent houses. Now, home assignment. Dear students, as I have explained the whole chapter to you, now let's do something. That is the first question which you have to do as homework. This is quite interesting, in which you have to draw, color and name different types of houses we discussed in the chapter. Like we discussed igloo, we discussed stilt houses, tent and many more houses. So draw the picture beautifully and color them. Second question comes, you have to write why houses are important for us. Why should we make houses? This question you have to answer in 5 points. Then the third and the last question, you have to name the factors responsible to construct a house. That what are the factors responsible while constructing a house? What do you think before constructing a house? This is all about the chapter. Hope you understood it. Hope you liked the presentation. And I hope you all will do assignment willingly. Enjoy your day. Take care.